So in the last unit, we got to this remarkable result. The next search direction is merely a linear combination of the current residual and the last search direction. Okay. Notice with this, it's very easy to determine actually what gamma sub k is, because we know that the next search direction is a conjugate to the previous search direction. So what we can do is we can say, well, let's take the previous search direction. Let's compute this right here. We know that that must be equal to zero. But what that means is that that's equal to pk minus 1 transpose A times the residual plus gamma k times pk minus 1 transpose A pk minus 1. So now we can solve this by noticing that we can bring this to the other side and then divide by that. So our gamma k becomes the negative of pk minus 1 transpose A rk divided by pk minus 1 transpose A pk minus 1. Okay? So now we can take this insight and we can say, okay, when we're ready to compute the next search direction, all we do is we check whether this is the first iteration, in which case we set it equal to the right-hand side. Otherwise, we compute this gamma k that we just described. And then we take our next search direction to be a linear combination of the current residual and the previous search direction. And what we have now is a practical algorithm, because at worst, we need to do one or more matrix vector multiplications. And at every step, everything is then totally prescribed. Now, it turns out that there are some variations on a theme that some people prefer, and that involves computing your alpha k and your gamma k slightly differently. But all of those are variations on this conjugate gradient method as we've presented it right here. Now, some of those variations you're going to explore through some homeworks.